fresh off one of the most controversial articles in Philadelphia sports history, maybe. The Philadelphia Eagles head coaching search seems to be coming to a close, and a lot of people are not going to be happy. I'm going to try to put a positive spin on this coming up next. Thanks for the click and welcome to the Eagles News Now podcast. I'm professional wrestler Chris Wilde, live from bar 4133. And if you're an Eagles fan, you had one hell of a weekend, from the controversial article about Carson Wentz from Jeff McClain to the controversial pick for head coach. Yeah, the Eagles are closing in on a head coach. Nothing is set in stone, but it looks like, and all signs are pointing to, the fact that Patriots offensive coordinator and former Denver Broncos head coach Josh McDaniels will be the Philadelphia Eagles' next head coach. Now, this pick confused me because I figured the Eagles would look for somebody that they could control, somebody like Deuce Staley or like Joe Brady, that don't have much of a resume in the NFL or a reputation like Josh McDaniels has. And I want to try to put a positive spin on this because I've been listening to the radio all day on WIP, nonstop negativity. I've also seen some articles and some tweets, more negativity. And look, it's just due. I mean, this guy has a bad reputation from when he was a head coach with the Broncos before. So let's get the negativity out of the way, and let's start with his head coaching job with the Denver Broncos. He was there from 2009 to 2010, went 11-17, and that is not the worst of it. It started really bad for Josh McDaniels, as when he got there, there was a big trade controversy. Now, he coached Matt Cassel to an 11-5 record with the New England Patriots after Tom Brady got hurt. I believe this, it was like second game of the season, and he wanted Cassel as his quarterback in Denver. One problem, and that was Jay Cutler, because he was still there. So the trade did not go down. It was supposed to go down. It got leaked that it was going to go down. This did not sit well with Jay Cutler. Long story short, he ends up going to the Chicago Bears, and the Denver Broncos get Kyle Orton, who, I mean, look, it's Kyle Orton is absolutely horrible. Okay, maybe not absolutely horrible, but he wasn't good. Let's put it that way. So Josh McDaniels suffered through two seasons with the Broncos, and a lot of that was his fault. He got fined $50,000 for filming a 49ers walkthrough while they played them in London. That sounds familiar because that's what his boss is famous for doing. And, you know, it's funny because Bill Belichick actually gave Josh McDaniels a book about how to run an NFL team. McDaniels called it the Bible. And I wonder if that's one of the chapters there. Look, for guys that cheat, they get caught a lot, and it's insane. You got to wonder how their relationships are. But nonetheless, not only did that happen, but Josh McDaniels carried the reputation of just being hard to work around. And look, I don't know if anybody else can relate to this. I know I can. There's always that one person that you work with that's a supervisor or they're in charge of something, and they constantly have to remind you that they're the ones in charge. Well, that was Josh McDaniels. He carried a Chip Kelly-like creepiness to him in Denver. I mean, look, quite frankly, he was a dick there. And there are reports and just really crazy, bad, negative articles about some of the things that he would do. Now, he was fired his 13th game into his second season, and he had to humble himself. He went to the St. Louis Rams, worked with Sammy Sleeves. That didn't end up too well. So his mentor, Belichick, took him back with the Patriots. And look, he's been successful for the past nine seasons. He's had a top five offense in points per game, and for seven consecutive seasons, which Tom Brady was the quarterback for most of them, except for the four games Jimmy Garoppolo had to serve during that Deflategate suspension. New England's had a top 10 offense in yards per game in six of those nine seasons, but last year they finished 27th in points and yards per game, and that's the first one without Tom Brady. Now, look, he had to work with Cam Newton, who every time he threw the football, it looked like he was throwing a gallon of water. I mean, it was just Cam Newton was absolutely finished. So with that being said, I don't know how to judge Josh McDaniels. Was it all Tom Brady? Was it a mix between the two? It's really hard to say. But it really, I mean, look, you tip the scales to Tom Brady as he's in the NFC Championship game next year. However, Josh McDaniels has been around a lot of winning. The guy has six Super Bowl rings. And the fact that he failed so horribly his first stint 11 years ago kind of tells me that he won't make the same mistake twice. And a lot of you are thinking, what are you talking about? 2018, he was supposed to be the Colts head coach. They named him the head coach. And he went ahead and said, no, thank you. I'm going to go back to the Patriots because they're promising me a head coaching job because Belichick is going to retire, which didn't happen. And Brady left instead, which kind of left Josh McDaniels looking even worse than before, if that was even possible. No, everyone's going, man, I thought this was going to be a positive thing on McDaniels. Well, look, the fact of the matter is, again, all of his offenses, most of them, except for the years with Kyle Orton and friggin' Cam Newton. Again, I don't name me another guy that could get a lot out of those guys in these situations. I don't know. But the fact that he's around a guy like Tom Brady, had the top offenses, that's something that you can bring here. Whether you're working with Jalen Hurts or you have to try to fix Carson Wentz, I think it's a good guy to put in that position. And also, I believe that he's going to have a good staff around him. Now, the Eagles interviewed Jared Mayo as head coaching candidate. He's only been a defensive coach for 2 years, a linebackers coach for the Patriots. But the Patriots defense has been really good the past 2 years. And words are that Mayo is a rising star as far as the coaches go. Now, McDaniels could bring him to Philadelphia to fill in that void at defensive coordinator, and I think that would be awesome. I mean, look at these numbers. Opposing quarterbacks that faced the Patriots had a 75.5 passer rating over the past two seasons, which is the lowest in the league. 35 passing touchdowns allowed, which were the fewest in the NFL, and 58 takeaways, which are the second most in the league. And it was horrible watching the Eagles this year barely ever get takeaways. So I would love to see Jared Mayo here as DC. And McDaniels, again, whoever his rest of his staff is going to be, it could be something that might not be the worst thing. Now, a lot of people hated when Doug Peterson was named head coach. I was not one of them. I want to find it so I can post it, but I actually called WIP for the first time ever to talk about how Doug could be a good coach. And I kind of feel like McDaniels could possibly be not the same as Doug, but he could have success here now that look, 11 years ago, I've done things 11 years ago that I would not do today. I made mistakes 11 years ago that I would not make today. Hell, I made mistakes 2 years ago that I wouldn't make today. But you would hope that he has grown as a coach. And the Eagles, I mean, are they really going to bring... Look, they went through the nightmare of Chip Kelly. Are they going to bring a guy in there like that? I mean, Chip Kelly shoved Howie Roseman into a locker, basically. Is that what they're going to bring back? I don't think so. And I don't think it would have entertained him all day long Sunday, if that's the case. Now, look, I've been very open that I want Deuce Staley or Joe Brady as the head coach here. It doesn't look like that's going to happen, and it looks like it's going to be Josh McDaniels. But again, Eagle fans, I don't think this is the worst thing. You want a different kind of offense, you're going to get it with Josh McDaniels. And he had very little, besides Tom Brady, I mean, they have very little to work with in New England, if you think about it. I mean, James White was, you know, their running back. It just... think of all the different wide receivers that they had that were just ho-hum guys. And again, I know a lot of this has to do with Tom Brady, a lot. But where we're at right now, I can't see. And look, I know a lot of people are going, well, why isn't he being interviewed any other place? And probably because what he did to the Indianapolis Colts. But, you know, guys like Deuce Staley and even Joe Brady aren't getting much attention other places either. So, I don't know, guys, but again, it's not the end of the world if he's the Eagles' next head coach. I'm already preparing myself for it, and I'm ready for it, and I'm very interested to see who the rest of his staff would be. Now, the Eagles could do something crazy like they also interviewed Todd Bowles, and they might be blown away by Bowles and hire him like out of nowhere as head coach. Brian Daboll already said he didn't want any part of Philadelphia, which is fine because, look, I don't see the appeal of him anyway. He's going to stay in Buffalo for another year, whatever. But you also got guys like Eric Bieniemy. Look, the Eagles and the Texans are the last two teams that need head coaches. Eric Bieniemy is still out there. I mean, there's so many guys still out there, so many good candidates that could be an Eagles head coach. And I'm ready for Josh McDaniels. I'm ready for it. I'm ready to hurt again. Yes. So with that being said, guys, it's not the worst thing. It is definitely not the worst thing. And some Eagle fans I talk to, they got something bad to say about every candidate. So We'll see, guys. It definitely, again, the Eagles do not make it boring. That's for sure. And it will not be boring if Josh McDaniels is the coach here in Philadelphia. I actually met Josh McDaniels a year ago while I was working a wrestling event in Boston. And I shook his hand and told him I was an Eagle fan, and he smiled. So he could have told me to F off, and he didn't. So, hey, growth. Thanks for watching, guys. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Go Birds. I'll see you later.
Say, without further ado, let's get into it.
I don't like hot stuff at all.
No, neither one of us like hot stuff.
Like, I hate it. Like, I don't, like, I get my wings mild.
Correct. Me too.
You know, but I don't know. I think I was...
But I don't know.
Honestly.
But I don't know.
But I don't know.
Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don't know. Honestly. I don